Hi, I'm Alex, and I'm going to show you how to use the FanFilm Effects Saberblade effect. Here we are in Final Cut Pro. We have some clips in here, along with some sound effects that I found on the internet. Here's how it sounds right now. But we probably want the lightsabers to look real, so we're going to use the effects. Now, first, some settings that you may want to use. I have my skimming and snapping turned off because it's helpful, but if you don't want to do that, that's fine too. And remember to have your inspector open by clicking the little knob button. Now we're going to open the Generators tab. It's the one with the little number 2 countdown on it. And we're going to go into Fan Film Effects. For this first one, we're going to use the free version of Saberblade. Just drag that onto your timeline. When you first drag it on, it'll be 10 seconds long. Just trim it down to the size of your clip. Now we're going to click on the Saberblade effect and look at our inspector. Now make sure that you're on the Generator tab, or else you won't see any of this. So I'm going to set the color to red because I'm doing the red lightsaber first. The first thing you're going to want to do in order to make all of this work is hover over here and click these four little plus buttons to make them turn orange. This is keyframing the clip so that when you move it around, it will animate itself instead of just moving the actual saber around. Now we're going to move it on the screen. This green dot is our start position, so we're going to put that at the handle of the lightsaber. And this red dot is our end position. Now, since you have it keyframed, we can use the arrow keys to skip ahead a few frames and just place it where it is now. It automatically moves itself because it is keyframed, but you may need to edit it a bit later just to make it precise. Some more options that we have to make it easier are visibility, so that you can only see the dots, and show wireframe, which shows a little red wire instead of the saber blade itself. But make sure to turn visibility back on and wireframe back off before playing the clip again. Another option that we have is thickness. This will adjust the thickness of the blade. You want it just enough to cover up whatever prop you are using for the blade. And the final option on the free version is the glow amount. This will set it to glow a lot more if you want it to glow a lot more, or a lot less if you want it to glow a lot less. Now that I am done the red lightsaber, I'm going to drag in a second saber blade generator effect for the blue lightsaber. Again, we're going to keyframe everything, and by default it is set to blue, but if you want it to be green, you can change that under colors as well. For this next clip, we're going to use the full Saberblade plugin. This basically works the same way, but we have a whole bunch of other options. So first, we're going to cut it down to the length of the clip. Next, we're going to keyframe it. This is the most important part, so don't forget to do this. This is where you click the little plus symbols beside the start position, start width, end position, and end width to make them turn orange. We have a few different things yet again. We have an end width, which basically makes it more triangular if you want it to be. We have thickness again. Tip length, which adds sort of a kite shape to it. If we turn up the thickness, we can see that. We have glow amount again. We also have flicker and vibration, which basically makes it flicker or vibrate between each frame automatically. We also have a whole spectrum of colors, so you can have any color. Purple, red, aqua, yellow, or even white and black. In this next clip, we're going to use something called the cutout mask. What the cutout mask does is when you have your saber blade go behind something, you can make it so that it looks like it is going behind something. We have our clip here, and at one point the saber blade goes behind a head. Right now, it just looks like the saber blade is on top of the head, but using the cutout mask, we're going to make it look right. We're going to turn on the cutout mask by clicking the little check mark down here. Now we're going to remember to keyframe all of these, mask point 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now we're going to place the cutout mask where the saber blade shouldn't be. Now these four gray dots, we're going to position where it shouldn't be, where the lightsaber shouldn't be. And you just keep doing this until it comes back out of from behind his head. The final thing that I'm going to do is show you how to make it look like the lightsaber is first coming out. Now for this, you don't want your prop lightsaber to be open. You want it to be closed. And we're going to place the saber blade where we think it would be. Now we're going to go to where you think the lightsaber should be fully out and keyframe the little keyframe next to blade length. Now let's go back to where it should start coming out, or the beginning of the clip, and set blade length all the way to 0. Now when we play that through, it looks like it's opening. Now sometimes this looks a bit too slow for you. And if it does look too slow, then it's a simple fix. The first thing you're going to do is select your generator effect. Then you're going to either right-click or hold control and left-click. You're going to go down to Show Video Animation and click that. And here we have a bunch of little options. Now, at the very top, under Saber Blade, it will show you all the keyframes that you have. So now we're going to skim through using the arrow keys to the point where I want my lightsaber to be fully up. And then we move the keyframe from when it is fully up all the way over there. You can click the X beside video animation to close it, and rewatch your final product. It's a lot better now. Remember, the opening the lightsaber with the blade length also works for closing it, just reverse it.